Why, hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages. Yeah, yesterday we set up a login system so that you can log into Playfab, and we went over that flow of setting up a form in Unreal Engine to do so. Then we went through sign up where you can register. Now, the aim of this was building up towards starting to use the kind of data that you can store against users on Playfab. And one use of it would be to create a leaderboard. We're still going to try and work towards that today, but there was a slight little hiccup in the plan. I can demonstrate what the hiccup was. So if we go into this game, so this is something that's been changed recently, and they're now moved over to Azure Functions, which I'm sure work perfectly well. But what we're going to do today is still learn a bit about what you need to know to set up a leaderboard. And we're going to do some client authoritative leaderboard work. We're going to figure out how to do that. We're going to figure it out as we go along this. We're going to try and use some of the documentation. We're going to Google search, I'm sure. We're going to try and figure things out. And that's what we're going to be doing today. So if I go in and I look in the automation tab here, you can see that I've got this revisions tab. And in here, this is how it used to be. You could write functions. You can do various things on the server then. We are going to do our best to get started with the leaderboard, as I said. So let's get started with that. I could log in. I could go into already signed up. I could type in my email address and then I could log in, and then it took us to this level. The first thing we're going to do, I'm going to move my login widget to be the first one, just so we start on that one. Second thing, I want to be able to just fill some text into the email and password. So let's go into here. It's going to be super quick. We're just going to get our input field just like before. We're going to promote this to a variable. So now what we should have, we have the ability in our login widget to click on these and set some pre-fill text in here. Okay, so that should be saved now. When we press play, I can just press login straight away. I need to give control back to the player. So I'm going to just do this, but we want to do this in the second level that we made. So we made a level called post Playfab login. It's going to be set input mode. So this should allow us, hopefully, to be able to have control once we've logged in. And voila, we can move around now at least, so we're not locked in place. Yeah, first off, we're gonna look at what I said was title data. So you find this down in the content section. So let's click on content. And in here is where our title data will be. So I've got one that I've made from before. I wonder, can I just get rid of this? Does it not let you just delete one? Surely you can delete, can you? Yes, you can, there we go. So it's no longer there. This is what it'd look like if you're coming in. In here, we're gonna add a new one. We give it a name. So this will be enemies per wave. And then we're gonna put in a value here. So let's say at the moment, it's gonna be 10 enemies per wave. So we're gonna press save, and that is up to date now. That's all you need to do. But we should have a look how we can actually go ahead. Let's go to Unreal, and we're gonna go, if you remember, all our Playfab interactions yesterday were via our game instance. So we're gonna go back into that Playfab game instance we made. We wanna go ahead and use our Playfab API in order to get hold of that data that we just made, right? So first off, let's make an event that we can call, shall we? Okay, so we're just gonna pretend that we've got a bit of a back-end game on us. So we're just gonna make a function. So we're gonna add a custom event. For now, I guess like we can just print it. Number of enemies. We need to call one of those Playfab functions. So let's have a look what we've got available to us. So we've got a get title data, and we're gonna go ahead and click on get title data. We're gonna drag this out and we're gonna see what does it need in order to, but we're just gonna go ahead and type in our key, and it's called enemies per wave. Let's just copy paste that in. So we're requesting the title data that's called enemies per wave. Because it gives you the same signature back, we can just keep reusing that, which is lovely. Now that it's been a success, before what we did with the success, if you remember, is we just loaded a map, right? Because all we needed to know is, oh, we logged in. So like before, we're gonna go and we're gonna break this down. So let's do a get string. We'll do that. And then we can make sure that we plug that same value in over here. All right, so now that we've gone and looked at this, we're getting some data back, and now we can just use this data. We've got it as a string. We're gonna give this a go, and I'm gonna show you it not working first as well. Let's go to our player character. Go get number of enemies from Playfab. Let's have a look what happens. Let's go to this is the level where we're gonna be logged into, and this is gonna be the first example of it going wrong. So let's see, so I press K. I said it'd go wrong, but I didn't expect it to go wrong in this way. Intentionally. All right, let's press play. I press K. Can you see that this says 10? Very small in the top in the top of the screen. It may not be too exciting. Let's make it really difficult. We now get 60. I just made the game really hard. So that dynamic data is pretty interesting because we could use that information in order to change the gameplay. So shall we do something very simple to demonstrate how it would change gameplay? We're not going to go very complicated at all. So let's see whether or not we can request it as a number or whether it does come through as a string. So let's press play. Let's press K. It still does come through. So it does read it for us. It'll send it along. Yeah, you can see it's 60.0 there. So good. We can test this quickly. So we should now get 3 enemy spawn. Great. So that's just a basic spawner, right? But the idea here is we can feed that value via Playfab instead. So we can change it dynamically. So now what we need to think is how can we arrange the flow of that data? So I guess what we could do is we need to think about how we're going to get the callback from this. So this data, we need to go ahead and set it in our enemy manager. We can get around this in a nice, easy way. Let's just go ahead and make a variable. And this is going to be public, so we can access it elsewhere. So then when we get this back, we'll print it. But we're also going to go ahead and set this value, right? So let's hold Alt, drag this on. It's going to be truncating because it's treating it as a float. But that's fine by me. We want to give Playfab a chance to come back to us and give us the answer, right? And then what we want to do is our wave spawner, wherever I made it, wave manager here. We're then going to go ahead and spawn enemies that way. What we're going to do is we're going to go and get that value from our player instance. Game instance, we want to cast this. And then what we want to do is we want to get hold of that number of enemies per wave. And now we don't need that local variable anymore. That works fine for me. So let's go back to our game. We'll go back to the main level, Playfab login level. Okay, so we'll give this a default value of 1. So if there's only 1 enemy spawning, we know it's using the default. But if we get 5 spawning, we know it's reading from Playfab. Okay, so I press 3 seconds goes by. Okay, here, can you see it says not authenticated? This was the error I was trying to show you earlier. But I think once you log in once, you're authenticated for a session then perhaps. And I think maybe that's why it worked earlier. So you've got to make sure that your player logs in so that they can make these requests. And now we get our 5 enemies spawning because it read the value from Playfab. So yeah, that's one use of how you can access data that's on your Playfab title. And we're going to now try and progress that a little bit to look at statistics instead. Something called Azure Functions. So if I go into players, what's my name, Dan? Okay, I just had to search. And you've got all of these different types of events now. So playstream events are a bunch of already implemented Playfab hooks. So when the player logs in, it will fire this event and you can kind of hook into it. This is where then you can add actions. So whenever we get this event, this is how you store individual data, and it can be strings. It can be, I think you can actually store different types of data as well. I don't have an exhaustive list here to go through. I've gone about this is if you were to create a leaderboard, it'll automatically go ahead and create a statistic for you, which is going to be what you are tracking in that leaderboard there. And let's make a new leaderboard and we'll call this top kills if we're doing a shooter game. And now you can see we have a leaderboard. It has no results, which is a sad state of affairs. I know. I'm sad too. But we're going to try and figure out now how we write to this. But for now, we're just going to, like we did, bind it to a key and just call it. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to make a new one now. We're going to create a custom event as well. We have our on failure and our on request. So we can do the failure quickly. We'll just do a create event. We'll call that on failure that we've been using the whole time. Happy days. So this will be input. Let's just do L this time because it's next to K. And we're going to give it a new number of kills. So let's just say we have killed 10 people this round. Let's see what happens, shall we? Is it going to work for us? Is it going to add anything to it? So we press login. Stats were sent. How exciting. Okay. Holy smokes. We've got a little bit of leaderboard data going in. You can control which way these statistics are updated, and that's important based on how you're doing it. Okay. So that was straightforward, right? I tell you what, shall we go ahead and add someone else into our database as well? All right. So now if we went into the statistics for Steve, and so if we say, okay, Steve has got most kills in a game of 80, because Steve is really good. We then press save, we go to our leaderboards, and most kills in a game, we can see that Steve is roaring ahead of Paul. We're gonna have a look now at how we can try and get hold of that information to pull it back. So I haven't done this bit before, but using the Playfab API is pretty straightforward. You normally just type in some of the keywords and there's a function for it, right? The nice thing about this is it's safe, again, the leaderboard, right? So the client can do this without you feeling like it's a risk, because all they're doing is reading data, right? So shall we have a look if we can figure out how to do it? Let's make a new event. This is going to be get leaderboard. We want to go here. We're going to call Playfab function, probably going to be called get leaderboard for a specific version. We'll leave that. The string field is going to be display name. Copy that. Get ourselves a divider again. Finally, we want to get the kills, this was, right? Okay, we're going to see if it works. Tiny leaderboard in the top left of my screen. Oh, I'm excited. Let's log in. And now we just got to press J. There it is. It happened so quick. We got to screenshot it. And then we're going to make this giant so we can appreciate it in all of its glory. Look at our leaderboard. It's a thing of absolute glory. There we go. Position 0 and 1. But yeah, okay. So hopefully today we've had a nice little insight into how we can store data, retrieve data, and use it in things like leaderboards.